Alright, we're going to go over solving linear equations in one variable. So this is going to be part one. So what is a linear equation in one variable? It means it's an equation, so there has to be an equal sign, that can be written in the form ax plus by equals c. So in other words, a, b, and c are just some numbers, and a can't be zero. So I've got three examples here. X equals 8. Now, does that look like AX plus B equals C? Well, you can make it look like that by writing it as 1X plus 0 equals 8, for instance. But the simplified way of writing that is X plus 8. The second one could be thought of as 3X plus 0 equals negative 4. And the last one is already in the form that we're talking about. So there are many other equations that you'll be able to put in this form, but just so you know, basically it means there's a single variable. It could be x, y, m, n, etc. And there can be some numbers, but there won't be no x squares, etc. One of the first properties we're going to use is called the addition property of equality. It says if a, b, and c are numbers, then A equals B and A plus C equals B plus C are called equivalent equations. Now, an equivalent equation means you will get the same solution to the problem. So basically, I think of it as this, is if you have two things that are equal to each other, like A equals B, you could add the same number to both sides of the equation. So you could add C, whatever that number could be. Now, it's true that that could be a negative number, so you could add a negative number to both sides, or that's the same thing as just subtracting the same number from both sides. One way of thinking about this is using a scale. So imagine if you had some sort of balancing scale here. I'm not an artist, but here is the center, and you've got like x pounds on the left and 3 pounds on the right. So if it balances, we could say x is actually equal to 3 pounds. And so if you add 3 pounds on the left side, it would tip, right? So this would be heavier on the left, but to keep things in balance, you're going to have to add 2 pounds on the right-hand side. So we started off with this equation x equals 3, and an equivalent equation would be x plus 2 equals 5. And what this means is the solution to either of these equations is the same. So in other words, x equals 3. If you replace x with 3, this is a true equation. And over on the right, if you replace x with 3, this is also a true equation. Usually we'll start over with the equation x plus 2 equals 5 and try to get the answer, which will be x equals 3. And of course, this one, it's easy to figure out in your head without using any algebra. I imagine most of you could figure out what plus 2 is 5. Oh, it's got to be 3. But we're going to go on to how can we use this property to solve it for simple problems like this, and then we'll do more complicated ones. All right, so let's start off with how would we solve x plus 2 equals 5 using the addition property of equality? So it's basically saying you start off with some number and someone added 2 and they got an answer of 5. So one way of thinking about this is just undoing what just happened to x. So you started with x and added 2. To undo it, you can subtract 2. Does that make sense? So we could get back to what x was equal to. But if you subtract 2 on the left side of the equation, you also have to subtract 2 on the right side. It's actually not a bad idea to even write what you're doing on both sides, subtract 2, so you remember what you did. This is good practice, although it's not necessary. Now, if you have x plus 2 and then you subtract 2, you know, these two are going to give you a 0, and x plus 0 is just x. You could always show more steps by writing x plus 0 first, and 5 minus 2 is 3, and we already knew that was the answer, right? Because this is one we could solve by inspection. Another way you can show the same thing, subtracting 2 from both sides. So think of it as just sort of undoing. You want to know what x equals, so if you add a 2, you're going to have to undo it. Usually you add going up and down. You could just subtract 2 from both sides this way. It's easy to see. You're like putting the minus 2 under its like term, right? 2 minus 2, so you have to put the minus 2 under its like term over here, right? These are just numbers. And then I get x plus 0. If you want, you could write x plus 0. This is an optional step. Or you could just write x equals 3. So this should be the answer as well. And you might even want to show this here. This is where you could see what you're doing. You're subtracting 2 from both sides. All right, now by inspection, you can go back and check your answer. And to check your answer, what you do is you write the problem over again, exactly as it was to begin with, and underline it and draw a T. This was in some other video where I showed you how to replace variables to see if it's the right answer. And then we're going to plug in the value for x to see if that's really the right answer. So there's only one place to plug in the x, right? It's right here. And then we simplify each side. So this is just 5. And then on the other side, there's nothing to do. And if it's the same number, that means this really is the correct answer, x equals 3. And the way to write that answer, if you're going to be formal about it, is use solution set, or you just put 3. It's up to you. All right, here's another problem. X minus 8 equals negative 15. Some of you might be able to do this in your head, but we want to do it using the addition property of equality. So look what happened. You started with the variable x, and you subtracted 8. So you want to undo that. I like doing it up and down, although you can do it across. So I'm just going to add 8 to both sides so that these will cancel. If you have minus 8 and then you add 8, that's going to give you 0. But whatever you do on the left side of the equation, you can only use the addition property of equality if you have an equation. So I'm going to skip the writing x plus 0, and I just get x equals. Now here you have to be very careful if you go up and down. Don't just add 15 and 8. It's negative 15 plus 8, so the answer is negative 7. Now if you did it the other way, x minus 8 and equals negative 15, you could have just shown it on the next step, plus 8 to both sides. And you're going to get the same thing, x equals negative 7. All right, so you can either add 8 to both sides sort of in a horizontal fashion here, or you could do it in a vertical fashion. So then we're going to check our answer to see if that's correct. So you copy the problem down the way it was originally, underline the whole thing, and draw a line under the equal sign. And then replace negative 7 in for x. So we're going to put in negative 7 for x. And then I have to simplify the left-hand side. Well, that's a negative 7 plus negative 8, right? If you want, you could write that as plus a negative 8. And so negative 7 plus negative 8 is negative 15. And on the left-hand side, there's nothing to do. Now, this is what a lot of people do. They don't pay attention and really do your addition correctly, and they just write the same number. But, of course, that's tricking yourself because, I know the real answer. The whole idea is for you to check to see if you really got the right answer. So the answer to this is x equals negative 7 is correct. So you could write the answer as negative 7, right? There's the answer. Or if you want to be formal about it, you could use these little solution set braces, which means you've checked your answer. All right, let's do another one. 4 plus n equals negative 9. All right, so here's n. Now, it'd be nicer if it was written as n plus 4, but it's not. So we still see that there was a 4 added to the n. So to undo that, you're going to have to subtract 4. The idea is to isolate the variable so it's all on one side of the equation. I'm going to do it up and down again. But again, it's up to you if you'd like to do it the other way, going across. So 4 minus 4 is 0. So I've got n equals, and then over here we're adding negative 9 and negative 4, so that's negative 13. Now I usually show my check right next to it, so I'm going to do it this time. 4 plus n equals negative 9. I'm going to plug in negative 13, and 4 plus negative 13 is negative 9, and on the right-hand side I have negative 9, so I've checked my answer. So there you go. You've already boxed your answer. You know it's correct. Or if you'd like, you can write it in the solution set. Or you could just write, oh, the answer is negative 13. Okay? All right, so go on to part two, and we'll just continue using the addition property of equality and maybe do a few more tricky problems. I hope you learned something. Remember, math is cool.